So there it was, above the flap in yesterday's Wisconsin State Journal. The Madison School Board agrees to go to referendum in November so that voters can decide whether to spend $26 million a year above the state spending cap for education in Madison into perpetuity. That's Latin for forever. The problem is it's the property tax in the first year, $35 on an average home. They're going to put it in over years. But that means in the second year, it's $70, the third year, $105, fourth year, $140. It just kind of goes up. And people live on fixed incomes. The way we pay for education has to be examined. Former Senator Mike Ellis of Neenah had his own plan at one point to equalize the property tax rate, as people with lower property values pay a higher mill rate than people who live in rich, more affluent areas, which is kind of fundamentally unfair. So what he proposes is to equalize the property tax rate. There's a way to do it so that people pay the same based on their property value. Then use state income and sales taxes to take care of special needs kids as designed and formulated by the Department of Public Instruction. Then, if a local school district wants to go beyond that and go to referendum, they can do that. But the way we do it now is we're relying on property value too much. It's unfair to children and families who live in urban poor or rural poor districts. And there ought to be a more equalized way to do it. Using sales and income taxes as a fair source of income, you could tweak the formula beyond that. But property taxpayers who are on fixed incomes simply are at a point where they may pay a higher property tax bill a month on their house paid for years ago than what their house was usually worth in terms of their house payments. It isn't fair. We base our education system to a large extent on property wealth, which is not, property taxes aren't always tied to the ability to pay or total income. They have to find a way to make it fairer before you should say yes on $26 million a year in perpetuity. Again, that's Latin for forever. My 2 cents, my 2 minutes are brought to you by Edge Construction and Capital Consultants. Bill McCashin, a lobbyist who worked for Tommy, who knows how to get things done downtown. We'll talk about this and more on the radio tomorrow at 8 on 92.1 FM, The Mic, The Mitch Henck Show. Talk to you then.